and welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing my September favourites because it's already October and I didn't organise myself to do this sooner. So these are my late September favourites. And I have got a box of things that I've been really loving over September and new things that I have been trying out and things that I've been going back to because I forgot how amazing they were and I've started using them really religiously again. So I will just get straight into it. Just a side note, I am suffering with a deadly cold at the moment and I'm not enjoying it one little bit, but that is why my voice sounds like I am a little bit underwater, so I hope you can forgive me. Sipping on orange juice. I'm just going to dive into my box and see what I pick up first. Okay, so the first thing is my Skin Food New Zealand Mud Mask, which is a little bit grubby because it's been in my bathroom for a really long time. But basically this is my favourite mud mask, skin face mask that I've ever used. It's absolutely amazing and I always feel so relaxed and cleansed after I've taken it off. When I rinse off, my skin is all in one even colour and I love how it sort of like tingles as it works. And also when this one dries, you can see the oil as it's being drawn out of your skin and I absolutely love that. I think that's so cool because you can see it working. Sort of like the Glam Glow one in that respect, the way that it like dries where you're not too disgusting, but then when you are really disgusting, it like shows you how it's taking it all out. So I really, really like that. And this isn't an expensive mask, it's only about £13 or £14. And I got mine off Amazon and it's lasted me months and months. And I've just started using it again because I've had it for ages. But yeah, I'm really, really loving it and I love how it makes my skin feel. My next things are my Crazy Colour hair dyes, which I have been using to make my hair a really weird icy pink colour. So I use a mixture now. I used to just use Candyfloss, but I went to my hairdresser, a really lovely girl called Katie, and she has like painted on my roots so that I can have my hair white blonde, and then she made this amazing colour concoction using Marshmallow and Lavender and Pinkissimo and Candyfloss, mixed it all up, put it on my hair, washed it off, and I ended up looking like My Little Pony. And I've washed it once so far and it's come out quite a lot, so I need to book another appointment and I need to find a way of not washing my hair so much to make it last a little bit longer. But those dyes are so beautiful and they come in so many different colours and they just make your hair look fantastic. And if you can get away with having colourful hair, I would say go for it because it's so much fun and you can get away with sort of looking like a mermaid and doing all these funky hairstyles and things. And I'd never thought that I wanted to do it, but now I've done it, I love it and I would do it all the time. And those are really, really cheap. I just get mine off eBay in packs of four and they're only about £13 for a pack of four. And you can mix and match colours and things and they are brilliant. Next I've got my Lord & Berry Crayon lipstick in the colour Fuchsia, and it's the one I'm wearing right now. And this is a product that when I first got it, I was so scared because it was so bright and I tried it on and I just thought, no, I'm never going to wear that. But when I wear it nowadays, I think it's just such a show-stopping colour and it's so bright and it's so pigmented and it's just a really gorgeous lip shade. And with my pink hair now, I can't wear red lipstick, so I sort of needed a bold lip colour that I could get away with. And yeah, September's been really, really hot in England, so this is technically a summer colour, but now it's getting into autumn, I'm probably going to venture more into my plums and my deep reds, because I think I can get away with that with pink hair. But this is such a fun colour, and the quality of these Lord & Berry lip crayons are amazing, and if you haven't got one, I'd recommend trying them. I've got two. I've got one in vintage pink, which is just like a really pretty everyday nude, and then I've got this one, which is just in your face. Next, I have got my Original Source Vanilla and Raspberry Shower Gel, and I tried this because my very good friend Emily from Emily Rose on YouTube recommended this in her drugstore favorites, and I rushed out to go and try it, and honestly, I can't even believe that it's real. It just doesn't even smell like it could possibly be real. And it's wonderful and it's completely natural and it's vegan and it's cruelty free and it's not tested on animals, tested on humans, which is good. And yeah, it's completely natural, there's nothing fake in here. It smells amazing, it's beautiful, it makes your skin feel so soft, it leaves the skin smelling like this stuff does. Honestly, just go into a Boots and smell this and you won't be able to not buy it. Next is my Batiste dry shampoo. Where would I be without my Batiste dry shampoo? It is my lifesaver. My hair gets so greasy and it's just because my head is sweaty. And I don't know why, but like my skin is oily on my face and my hair is oily. And then the rest of my body isn't really oily. I've just got a sweaty head, which is so annoying. But yes, my Batiste. This is my favourite flavour smell. And it's the tropical one. And it's coconut and exotic. It smells really nice and it leaves your hair looking fresh again, and it sort of gives it a lot more volume. And you know, everyone just needs a dry shampoo, and I think this is the best one. Now I'm on to an old faithful, and I feel so guilty because I just did not like this when I first got this. I was so excited to get it. I bought it straight away. Actually, I got it for Christmas. I asked for it for Christmas straight away. I got it. I was amazed by it and I was obsessed with it, but then I just couldn't find any looks that suited me, and I just felt like the colours didn't suit my skin tone, and I was like a bit upset because I just felt like, oh, I wish it looked better on me. But now I've been using it a whole lot more and I've been experimenting with it a lot, and I just absolutely love this palette. The shades are absolutely gorgeous, and I can't believe that I didn't find anything I liked when I first started using it. It's just, this shade here, Trick, is the most beautiful shade you'll ever try. It's like this really unique rose gold shade, and you can just create some really gorgeous smoky eyes with this. And to me, now I've been using it, I don't feel limited with the fact that they're all rose toned. I just feel like they're all so pretty, and you know, every girl needs a lot of pink eyeshadows. I mean, why not? Next is a new purchase, and it is my Boudoir Eyes palette by Too Faced, and the shades in this are really, really gorgeous too. I've been using this lots and lots and lots, and I think that they're meant for like really sexy looking eye looks, and I'm not really the sexiest person, but honestly, the shades are really gorgeous. I've reviewed this on my blog and did all swatches and things, but the quality of Too Faced eyeshadows, like, I'm newly converted. This is my first ever Too Faced product, and ever since I got it, I've just been reaching for it over and over because the quality of the eyeshadows are so good. They blend so well and they're so pigmented, and I can just tell they're gonna last ages because I've barely like scraped the surface just because they've got so much colour in them. So yes, I'm very impressed with Too Faced, and I will be buying lots more Too Faced stuff in the future. Next is my Gosh Melon blusher, which has impressed me so much since I got it. I was literally running into Superdrug. I needed a peachy blush because all my blushes are coral, and coral blushes do not suit me, and I only just learned not to buy coral blushes. So I picked up this one, and I've got it on now, and it's just a gorgeous, really natural looking peachy blush shade, and I can't fault it at all. It's the Superdrug's own brand, that's Gosh, and for how much it was probably about $5.99, so no money whatsoever. You get a big, like a nice big pan of it, and I'm just so impressed with it, and it's been my go-to blush. Like, I'm trying to save my deep throat because my deep throat is my ultimate favourite blush, and deep throat is a lot pinkier, but this one is such like a nice summery, just like a really even glowing sheen that's not over the top or anything. It's just gorgeous, and I can't fault it. I'm really happy with that Superdrug purchase. And now my last two products are two foundations, which I know I ramble on so much about. The first one is my NARS Sheer Glow Foundation, which I'm wearing now because I'm ill and I'm trying to brighten up my face and my complexion. And honestly, this foundation, when I got it, it just completely changed how I look at foundations. No other foundation really compares to this one. It's such good quality, and it's just so beautiful on your skin. It feels lovely, it doesn't budge anywhere, and it just makes you feel like you look amazing because you know you've got this really expensive stuff on your face, and it just gives you so much confidence. I try and save this as much as I possibly can. I try and stay away from it because I know that once it's gone, it's going to take me so long to justify buying another one. But it's my ultimate favourite foundation. I am in the shade Santa Fe, and you have to try this. If you only buy one really expensive piece of makeup in your life, make it this one because it's the best. And then my last one is one that I didn't think that I would ever put in a favourites video ever, because I loved this when I first got it, then decided I absolutely hated it, and there were so many more better foundations out there. But since having pink hair, I have realised that you really need a full coverage, and that is why my MAC Studio Fix Fluid in NW15 is back as one of my ultimate favourite makeup products for this month. It just gives you such a perfect, flawless coverage, and although I do find it to be a bit heavy, and I find that it melts a bit after you've had it on for a really long time. The coverage and the flawlessness of the look that you get when you've used this is incomparable. You cannot find another foundation that's going to make you look so flawless in your skin tone. So for that reason, MAC is back up there. It's like once you use this and then you go back to a drugstore foundation, you can really tell the difference. You know that you've been using a really high quality foundation because other foundations just do not compare. They don't give you the same amount of coverage as this one does. And although it's really expensive, again, same as the NARS, it's so worth the money if that's the kind of thing that you're looking for. If you need really covering up your spots, if you really need to make your face look nice and flawless, then that is the perfect foundation and I'm really loving it again. And I'm sorry I ever doubted you. So those were my favourites for the month of September. I really hope you enjoyed watching that and let me know if you like any of these products as well and if you've been using them and loving them same as me. Apologies for my illness, I'm sure I'll be better soon and I've been uploading lots on my blog because I've been ill and bedridden, so you can always check those out. And yeah, thank you again for watching and I will see you in the next video. Bye! Just a side note, the music I've used in this video is my wonderful boyfriend's very talented band. They're called Tiny Folds. They're based in the southwest of England and they're like indie alternative rock and I absolutely love their music and I'm very grateful that they have let me use it in my videos. So yes, thank you again and I will see you very soon. Bye!